Dr. Dre.
Hey, hey.
LL Cool J is hard as hell.
Yeah, yeah. So what does LL really stand for? Ladies love, living large, licking lips. Well, I'm here because I personally think it stands for living legend. L, do you remember a story you told me about leaving Def Jam? You were the first artist on Def Jam. You recorded all of this music and delivered all of these albums. Then fast forward to this, your deal is up. And you told me you were really expecting a really high dope parting gift, right? Do you remember what you told me you got? A cheap watch. Right? Well, now I guess you know what time it is, right? I mean, the folks at Def Jam probably could have done better with their parting gift, but they knew exactly what they were doing when they signed you as their very first act. LL was 17 years old when his debut album came out. It not only put Def Jam on the map, but it launched a fucking superstar. Now, whenever I hear the first album radio, it immediately transports me back to when I was just getting started as a DJ behind the turntables. I started off practicing, mixing and scratching, rocked the bells in my garage, and then I took that shit to the club and watched the club go crazy. Really. LL Cool J gave us 13 studio albums over 3 decades. How about that? He went from the sonic brutality of Mama Said Knock You Out to a silky ballad like I Need Love, right? And also smooth R&B and pop influence songs like Around the Way Girl, Doing It, Going Back to Cali, I Don't Think So. L. You know that old hip-hop term, right? It ain't where you're from, it's where you're at, right? Where do you live now, LL? California. Well, I'm here to show you some California love. All right. LL's body of work is some of the most diverse hip-hop has ever seen. He became rap's first pop superstar while staying true to his roots, representing Queens, New York. He's hit that unique space that crosses and bridges generations, the rare artist beloved by you, your mom, and all of your kids all at once. How many artists in the rap game are relevant after 30 years? Most of you don't know this, but LL Cool J termed the phrase GOAT, the greatest of all time. Yes, he's the one that actually came up with that phrase. So L, that parting gift that you got, it was just a placeholder for tonight. Something bigger was always in store to celebrate you, my man. So here's a look at my man LL Cool J's extraordinary life and his journey and the reason why we're here tonight.
Quick like lightning, too exciting, lover of ladies, don't allow biting, level-headed leader, toy boy feeder, good love life and a rhyme by the beater, looking, learning, the one you're liking, listening, you will love what I'm writing, ladies love, long heart and lean, and now you know what LL means.
LL Cool J is hard as hell.
LL Cool J is rock and roll. He is Elvis.
He has so much sauce and so much swag, but he most definitely
was lyrically out there annihilating.
He knew that he was the biggest star on the stage.
No, I still want more. I want to sit next to Bruce Springsteen and Michael Jackson and be just as respected for what I do.
He could battle your ass, he could do a love song, and he could do something that's dynamic that will totally destroy. LL destroyed careers.
Yes, I roundabout way discovered LL Cool J. Just want to say that on the record.
I got a demo tape from a guy named Ladies Love Cool J sent to my dorm room.
I used to listen to all the demo tapes, and it was very, very good. And so I was like, Rick, you gotta, you know, listen to this tape.
I got lots of demo tapes sent to the dorm room, but this one was really, really special.
Went to meet Rick down at Five University Place. He was staying in the NYU dormitory. He was in college.
I remember when he first came down, he was just very confused by the whole scene.
Rick came down dorm, he came out the elevator. He was a white guy. I thought you was black. He said, so we went upstairs.
And he came to my dorm room, we had a meeting and said, let's make records, and shook hands, and that was our deal. I need a beat.
LL was our apprentice. LL was the guy we passed the torch to. MTV recorded one of our early shows, Run DMC Live at the Ritz. You see this kid in a light blue Kangol and a light blue Izod shirt up front studying me and Run.
Run DMC, I totally respect. I always looked up to them. I always will respect them and love them because I feel like they open the doors.
This culture produces its first bona fide star.
His introduction to the hip-hop world via the Crush Groove movie was one of the most impressive, jaw-dropping debuts that hip-hop has seen.
Sorry, man, auditions are over today, all right?
Box.
What's this, man? No, man, come on, man. Through,
all right? LL's King Arthur moment, pulling Excalibur out of the rock and saying, everybody, it's over.
My radio, believe me, I like it loud. I'm the man with the box that can rock the crowd.
I pulled my sword out and went fully. You know what I mean?
Sing. My name is Cool J, I devastate the show, but I couldn't survive without my radio.
LL is phenomenal because he existed, dominated, and succeeded in an era that was mostly groups. He could do Going Back to Cali with Rick Rubin. It was so avant-garde.
That was fly to me, you know, it was black and white. The music was, it was like fast and different. I like when LL said,
small, heel, tall. She said she liked the ocean.
I felt like people might have thought, like, well, this is a little soft for L. Like, where he going with this?
There I was, giggling about the games that I had played with many hearts, and I'm not saying no names. Then the thought of,
why'd you make the song, I Need Love?
I needed it.
It's called being real. You know what I'm saying? Everybody needs love. Only suckers are scared of love.
It made the women melt, because that was the first time kind of hearing like a vulnerability. That opened that door for a whole nother lane.
I felt like, you know, maybe I was losing it or I was slipping, or because I felt like there was a backlash against everything that I represented in hip hop. And I told my grandmother that. And she was like, look, just go down in the basement, write yourself a song. Knock him out.
Don't call it a comeback. I've been here for years. I'm rocking my pants, putting suckers in fear. Making the tears rain down like a monsoon. Listen to the bass go boom, explosion.
LL has had about five major comebacks in hip-hop.
LL's greatest strength as a rapper is confidence.
I never give up in nothing.
He's not an OG. He is the G.
He has this, I'm sexy, but I'm not trying to be sexy.
I want a girl with extensions in her hair, bamboo earrings, at least two pair.
You felt like, oh, that could be me. I got the bamboo earrings on. It was hip hop, but it was sexy.
I love it when a woman is scared to do a thing.
I'm doing it, I'm doing it, I'm doing it well.
I represent
Brooklyn queen. She was raised out in Brooklyn.
LL has always been my forecast for where hip-hop was going.
Def Jam signed me to hit the lottery. It wasn't free, but don't call it a robbery. I'm the greatest of all time. They call me Big L.A.
LL not only succeeded, he dominated, he influenced, and he intimidated.
I think LL's greatest character trait is the fact that he listens to his musical collaborators. You can tell he listens to Rick Rubin, that he listened to Marley Marl, that he listened to the Trackmasters. They both rode each other to glory.
I don't know how it happened. I'm not smart enough to orchestrate this. I was just blessed. I'm the greatest of all time. Your man is very grateful. Because I know it doesn't have to be like that. I know that I don't even have to have a career right now. You know how many record companies I begged to put me on before I got down with Def Jam? I want to max out everything that's inside of me. I want to die empty.